Hi friends, welcome to Lucid Means program brought to you by Neo IAS. Our today's topic is National Commission for Backward Classes. It has been recently in news with reference to the 123rd Constitutional Amendment Bill of 2018, which in fact comes under the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Actually, the bill grants constitutional status the National Commission for Backward Classes and places it on par with the National Commission for Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe. You would have noticed that both the houses of the parliament have passed the bill in order to grant the complete power to safeguard the rights and interests of OBC. The National Commission for Backward Classes, which was created as a statutory body, was given limited powers. Thus, the new bill, when enacted, will make NCBC not only a constitutional body, but brings it at par with the status of National Commission for SEST. In fact, it empowers the National Commission of Backward Classes to hear the complaints of OBCs, protect their interests, and safeguard their rights. So, in this context, before getting into its provisions in detail, we will see what led to bringing such an amendment. Obviously, the commission was the outcome of a famous case, that is Indira Chennai versus Union of India case. In fact, it's a bit large one. So the case is given in detail in the material, and friends, you can download the material from the link given below and you can go through it. So that now we'll go ahead. What does this constitutional status to NCBC really mean? I repeat. What does this constitutional status to National Commission for Backward Class really means? The foremost thing is that it makes the body more efficient. As the commission is merely set up under an act, the decisions taken by the commission was simply superseded by the government previously. So that making it a constitutional body stops the possibility of this situation being repeated. Given the fact that now it will have a much better status as being a constitutional body. So that's it. And that's why the constitutionalization of NCBC becomes relevant. Now we'll see the key features of this bill. It is now having all the powers of a civil court, and in addition to it, it can make recommendation with regard to OBC, socially and economically backward communities, to be included in the list for their benefit. It provides the authority to examine the matters, and also it authorizes the president to specify the socially and economically backward class in various states and union territories. And it provides the scope for consultation with the governor of the concerned states. And sorry, it's a repetition here, but still, I remind you that National Commission for Backward Class has the power of a civil court. In addition to it, NCBC helps the community to come out of the neglect that it was feeling earlier. Now we'll see its composition. The Act provides that the commission shall consist of 5 members, that is a chairperson who should be a judge from a Supreme Court or a High Court, and a social scientist, and 2 persons who is having special knowledge in matters related to backward class. And finally, a member secretary who has the experience as a central government officer, as the secretary to the government of India, and also their tenure is of 3 years. Now the functions. Now the important functions are the inclusion and exclusion to the list of the communities notified as backward class, especially for the purpose of job reservation, will be done by NCBC. That is, it will be done by the National Commission for Backward Classes. Hope it's clear. Job reservation will be done by NCBC. And the body inquires into the specific complaints regarding violation of rights of backward class. And also, investigation and monitoring purpose will be done in the implementation aspect, with that they will have to present the annual report to the president regarding the working of NCBC. And finally, all these reports will be tabled in the parliament as well as in the state legislative assemblies. Now we'll see the merits. Why this change, or what is the special feature of this change. That it aims to provide justice to the socially and economically backward sections of the society. At the same time, it helps to bring in social equality. It also ensures women representation. Actually, in the 5-member committee that we have mentioned before, that is constituted as per the recommendation, one should be a woman. So, they ensure the women representation and the commission. And a key feature is that it does not encroach into the powers of the states, because the states will continue to have their own commissions. And finally, the amendment makes the NCBC on par with the constitutional commissions already existing for scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. Now, the challenges we'll have to face are, like, many states have not implemented even 27% of preservation to other backward classes, that is the so-called OBC. So, in this context, it's a challenge that to go ahead with the NCBC and its new recommendations. And the grassroots level implementation is a Herculean task. The negligible representation of OBCs in the Supreme Court and High Court is yet another concern. And finally, the scope of reservation is limited when Niti Aayog is promoting private-public partnership. So all these challenges has to be taken into consideration. We have to find solution for all these problems to go ahead with these changes that we have brought in the structure and functioning of NCBC with this 123rd constitutional amendment. As a way forward, there is a need to provide proper representation to the backward class in the deprived section to join the national mainstream, so that to a great extent we can bring changes. And proper reservation should be given on the basis of the census conducted by the government themselves. And also sub-categorization of OBC will ensure increased access to the benefit to that particular class. And that's all for the day. Thank you. Wish you all good luck.